I want to talk about letting life transform you. Setting out on an adventure like this is about shaking up your life on every level, every molecule. And it's about getting out there to experience nature in a really, really intimate way. And it's such a metaphor for exercise and how you really have to just get out and move your body and let life, that life energy, come in and shake up your cells, open things up, let things move. And you know, it's hard to do. It's hard to get motivated to get out there and move your body. And it's even hard sometimes on a boat. But I'm so reminded every day by just the beauty that surrounds us that really encourages me to just naturally get out there and swim, and the dolphins and the rays, and just being out in an outdoor yoga studio. And it takes a lot of self-discipline to, first of all, get ourselves out here, and self-reliance. And so it's, you know, doing any kind of exercise where you're moving is really a self-disciplined, self-motivated effort. And it comes from deep within. And so I just wanted to share a little bit of what it's like for me exercising out here in nature and having Sugar with me and Nick and this just beautiful environment. I feel so fortunate. And we're here on our final week or two in the Bahamas, and I'm just trying to soak it all in. It makes exercising a lot easier knowing that I'm not going to be in this playground with this natural inspiration, but I'm hoping that through this experience, and I'll be able to report back to you in a few weeks, that I feel an internal resilience or motivation to continue exercising, continue moving, and just, you know, making room for that vitality. I'm really curious to see how this experience on the water is transforming my life. And I just love spending this time with our little Shuggy. She's almost 14 and she's precious.
If you think that you are only inside your skin, you define yourself as one very complicated little curlicue, way out on the edge of that explosion, way out in space and way out in time. Billions of years ago, you were a Big Bang. But now you're a complicated human being. And then we cut ourselves off like this and don't feel that we're still the Big Bang. But you are. Depends how you define yourself. You are actually, if this is the way things started, if there was a Big Bang in the beginning, you're not something that is a result of the Big Bang on the end of the process. You are still the process. You are the Big Bang, the original force of the universe, coming on as whoever you are. See, when I meet you, I see not just what you define yourself as, Mr. So-and-so, Miss So-and-so, Mrs. So-and-so. I see every one of you as the primordial energy of the universe coming on at me in this particular way. Thank you. I know I'm that too. But we've learned to define ourselves as separate from it. And so what I would call a kind of a basic problem we've got to go through first is to understand that there are no such things as things. That is to say, separate things or separate events. That is only a way of talking. And if you can understand this, you're going to have no further problems. I once asked a group of high school children, what do you mean by a thing? And first of all, they gave me all sorts of synonyms. They said, it's an object, which is simply another word for a thing. It doesn't tell you anything about what you mean by a thing. Finally, a very smart girl from Italy, who was in the group, said a thing is a noun. And she was quite right. A noun isn't a part of nature, it's a part of speech. There are no nouns in the physical world. There are no separate things in the physical world either. See, the physical world is wiggly. The clouds, mountains, trees, people are all wiggly. Only when human beings get working at things, they build buildings in straight lines and try and make out that the world isn't really wiggly. But here are we sitting in this room, all built on straight lines, but each one of us is as wiggly as all get out. Now then, when you want to get control of something that wiggles, it's pretty difficult, isn't it? You try and pick up a fish in your hands and the fish is wiggly and it slips out. What do? To get hold of the fish? You use a net. And so the net is the basic thing we have for getting hold of the wiggly world. And so if you want to get hold of this wiggle, you've got to put a net over it. And I can number the holes in a net. So holes up, so many holes across. And if I can number these holes, I can count exactly where each wiggle is in terms of a hole in that net. And that's the beginning of calculus. The art of measuring the world. But in order to do that, I've got to break up the wiggle into bits. And I've got to call this a specific bit, and this the next bit of the wiggle, and this the next bit, and this the next bit of the wiggle. And so these bits are things or events. Bits of wiggles.